Seriously, Storm, it feels like Mercury is going into retrograde every other day. I hear it from our clients, I hear it from so many people. How often does Mercury go into retrograde?
Jackie, not as often as you think. It only happens 3 to 4 times a year. And that is why we created Astromagic products for you. Although it seems like Mercury is retrograde every other day, it is more accurate to say the influence of all the planets affect you. Our solar system, believe it or not, is 4.5 billion years old. And the planets, they move every single day, giving us an opportunity to change and transform our lives.
Listen, trying to master all of this planetary magic on the fly is so daunting. And so many people just want to give up trying to understand it. And that's why we created Astromagic, because it simplifies this process and puts you in charge of your relationship with the planets in 4 easy steps. Step 1, clarify your issue, decide what the problem is. And once you decide what the problem is, you go to step 2 and you pick your planet. And we have 10 planets to choose from. And then once you pick your planet, you go to step 3, you read about your sun sign and the planet and how it all interacts together. And then go to step 4, which is setting your intention, lighting your candle, and stepping into a whole bunch of astro magic. Aligning yourself with the purpose and energy of the planets creates ease where you're struggling with its particular vibration. This alignment opens up opportunities that are unique for you and your sun sign to connect with, amplify, and direct the power of the planet, bringing a bit of your own magical influence into life circumstances.
So, you know, Jackie, planetary magic has been practiced for over 4,000 years. Now, I've been studying this for a long time, but for a beginner, it's a lot to catch up on. With Astromagic, you will find yourself on your way to mastery before you even know it. This ancient system of magic is perfectly balanced and shows us how the planets govern our lives. Astromagic helps you leverage this energy in a multidimensional way, internally with our spirit, mind, and emotion, and externally with the circumstances and influences in our daily life. So, as this really, really cool occult book from 200 current events, okay, CE, the Emerald Tablet, one of the earliest books of occult thought, says, as above, so below. You can use Astromagic to channel these energies in your life, and guess what? You can receive any result that you want.
Your sun sign, when you fully align with it, becomes your star power. I watch so many magical practitioners get shy about their sun sign, thinking it can't be that easy to find their superpower. Yet I think one of our purposes in life is to transform into an empowered, well-adjusted version of our sun sign. And also, our star power brings the right people into orbit around us, the ones that can help us realize our destiny, and then you get to help them in return.
Solar magic is one of the most potent forms of astromagic. The sun god Apollo broke curses and he brought light to hopeless situations. Nowadays, curses aren't a Greek tragedy. They come in a variety pack of sizes, usually disguised as self-defeating behaviors. Low self-esteem, lack of confidence, depression, anxiety, and even phobias. However, you can use the sun to receive the favor of authority figures, charm others, and guess what? You can improve whatever ails you.
The moon has eternally been driving our life cycles, reminding us of the impermanence of anything we try to desperately hold on to. Yet at the same time, that moon, she shows us how to manifest into our lives what we need and desire. Embracing your relationship with the moon through your own moon sign or what sign the moon is in eases that primal emotional drive that can cause chaos. Because when you're out of alignment with the moon, your raging hormonal responses, inner and outer, prevent you from truly embracing who you are and what you really want. So flow with your moon sign into your special flavor of magic.
There's an old adage that says, in order to care for someone else, you first must learn how to care for yourself. Many of the problems that we face come from a lack of self-care. The moon is the ruler of the body, our ability to nurture ourselves, our emotional well-being, and governs the cyclical changes of everyday life. Sometimes you need to take a break from everything and everybody and get your own needs met. In other words, do you.
Here's a tip from your Aunt Jackie. There is your truth, their truth, and universal truth. And rarely are all three present at the same time. When there's an information gap, We are all prone to fill in the gaps with a story that aligns with their own subjectivity and our own life experiences. And when you pull in the energy of the planet Mercury every time you struggle with learning that universal truth, you will be pulled out of your own story and the assumptions that are within that story. Mercury helps you open up your mind, your spirit, and emotions to the bigger truth. And that truth is rarely what we think it is.
In the information age, the truth has become peculiar. And there are many versions of the truth based on individual beliefs. However, sometimes we need to see the real truth. In myth, Mercury was the god that governed communication. And in astro magic, Mercury is great for improving communication, making business deals, financial transactions, and even to confuse one's enemies. Mercury is also the planet to provide you with necessary information to make a major decision. And ultimately, you stack the deck in your favor.
Take off that old assumption that Venus brings romance and lifelong love. Mm-mm. Venus gives you the permission to unapologetically pursue and attain the desires you have at this moment. You know, our childhood was a mission to temper the drive for instant gratification, but our adulthood is a journey to find those desires once again and pursue them. Venus shows us that those desires are easier to attain when we have help. So she also draws to the people who desire you and desire your attainment of your goals. So you get to be that bitch and get everything your heart desires.
Venus is the Roman goddess of love. Now, she's not a sappy, desperate woman trying to score a man. She is the beloved, and she attracts to her whatever she truly desires. In astro magic, Venus is the ultimate glamour spell. She promotes attractiveness. She brings you new relationships. She rules relationship matters and also governs money and financial prosperity. Utilizing the power of Venus, you become in charge of your own power and control your own resources with elegance, grace, and inner beauty. In other words, you become that bitch.
Seriously, there is nothing wrong with winning, and Mars will teach you that. Even when everybody wins, each person wins something different, and you are the only person that wins your specific prize. Ditch the responsibility of making sure everyone gets a fair share and let the divine sort out what is best for you and what is best for others. If you're too concerned about fairness for everyone, you end up losing. We're all responsible for our own choices, and Mars supports going for that win, even if we have to fight for what we want.
Do you need the upper hand in your life? If so, Mars, the warrior god, is more than willing to help. Mars likes to fight. And if something is worth fighting for, then you just have to go after what you want. In astro magic, Mars gives you the edge in competition, secures work, and promotes an increase in energy and personal power. Mars can also help promote strategic action and give you the edge in business matters.
Jupiter gives us the permission to go big and make our dreams come true. It's scary to dream too big, to go for what you really want. It's audacious to think you deserve all that. And Jupiter not only applauds that audacity, but also trades on it to make it manifest in your life. Do this for a second. Think about your biggest dream. Now make it bigger. Make it crazier. Make it more. That feeling you get when you play with a possibility in your mind is a seed of the expansive Jupiter energy. Turn that dream, that big audacious dream, over to him, and he is going to put the opportunities to make it happen in your path.
Everyone needs a guardian angel or a lucky star, and Jupiter delivers. Jupiter is the cosmic Santa Claus who expands our lives and offers us protection. In astro magic, Jupiter is concerned with making your life bigger and better. He helps you break through obstacles and provides blessings, both materially, spiritually, and academically. Jupiter is also a valuable asset in legal matters. So when needed, reach for your lucky star.
Believe it or not, I love Saturn. Saturn brings structure to my life and tells anything that's not supportive of that structure to get the F out. Saturn can be used to curse anything or anyone out of your life, including your own bad habits and your own fears and your own self-defeating behaviors. And don't forget, Saturn is the Lord of Karma, so make sure your actions are in line or you're going to get that ricochet backlash. He also teaches us to be a little bit slower in our reactions, helping us play that long game that is filled with wisdom and patience.
If you're looking for an operational definition of life's difficulties, it can be summed up in one word, Saturn. In astrology, Saturn's keywords are limitations, frustrations, boundaries, and he is the Lord of Karma. Saturn is primarily a binding spell in astromagic and can be used to restrict others from trespassing against you or to simply get the nasties out of your life. When all other avenues fail, magically commanding someone to get the F out is a viable solution.
Don't be scared. It's only Mercury retrograde. Mercury retrograde gets a bad rap these days. He gets blamed for every stressful moment, broken item, lost digital file, and bump in the road. It's not Mercury's fault. It's really our own resistance to the gift of the new path that a Mercury retrograde brings. When Mercury is in his dark retrograde aspect, he will bring a deep dive into your life and show you the weak points in your life and give you the aha awakening on how to fix it before it gets worse. Are you ready for this gift?
3 to 4 times a year, Mercury decides to turn backwards. Of course, problems with communication, travel, and electronic devices occur during these cycles. In astromagic, we can use Mercury retrograde to review our past, revise our plans, and self-correct. You can also use Mercury retrograde to release the past and move confidently into the future. Using Mercury retrograde neutralizer can help reduce the way the retrograde cycle affects you, and can be used to repair any damage that may have occurred while the retrograde was active.
Because life rarely opens up for me to take advantage of the exact moment of the full moon, I give myself a 3-day window to let go and launch my magic into the universe. The full moon wants to support what you are ready to let go of, banish, or release. It can be getting rid of your most self-defeating behavior, or you can release an idea that is ready to take physical form in your life. Schedule time in that 3-day full moon window to contemplate what in your life no longer serves you. Old goals you may have completed or changed your mind on, old wounds, bad days, and relationships that just don't work.
There's one thing guaranteed in life, everything changes. In astromagic, the moon rules change and is one of the most significant timing planets, which is why witches have such an affinity with her. The moon has several different phases that are significant, but the two primary phases are the new moon and the full moon. The full moon reflects a 2-week period of clearing out the old and is great for letting go of negative behavior patterns, people, and cleaning the slate to make way for a new beginning at the next new moon.
The magical influence of the new moon is growth in its primal form. This energy of growth takes hold of your strongest intention that's in alignment with your body, your mind, your spirit, and your emotions. If nothing else on the new moon, be intentional on what you are giving the green light to grow. At the very least, sneak a moment of spiritual self-care on the new moon by breathing into life what you want to take root in this next cycle of the moon.
The new moon is our monthly reset button. She signifies new beginnings, new potentials, and most importantly, growth. The 2-week process of the new moon culminates at the peak of the full moon.